Hello children, today let us learn 7th class chapter 8 Industrial Revolution. In the previous chapter you learned about the various ways in which things are made by artisans. We also read that many of them are not able to compete with machine-made products and that many people have stopped practicing their professions. In this chapter, we shall explore how machines have come to dominate the way in which products are made and how they impact the lives of people. Let's start with increasing control of traders. From 1500 BCE to 1800 BCE, trade between countries in America, Europe, Africa, and Asia increased manifold. Textile trade too began to expand. European traders began to use putting out system. Putting out system means these traders gave advances to small farmers and artisans to produce textile goods. During this period, income from farming was low, and many peasants lost their farms and grazing lands. Therefore, textile work helped them to make a living. Under putting out system, a cloth trader in Britain purchased cotton from a supplier and carried it to the spinners. Then, the yarn was taken by the trader to the next stage of production, the weavers. The cloth was then taken to the fullers and finally to the dyers who gave it color. These different activities could be done in different parts of the country, but the finishing work was done in London before it was sold in other countries. Thus, textiles goods were produced by a large number of producers who were controlled by traders. There was no system as in a factory. That is, the different stages of producing cloth did not happen in the same place but in different households. Each trader engaged 20 to 25 craftspersons at each stage of production. Sometime later, the traders brought the craftspersons under one roof so that they could explain their requirements and organize the production more effectively. They set up small workshops called manufactories. The craftsmen brought their own tools and worked with raw materials given by the trader. Then, the trader took the product and sold it in the market. In this way, slowly, the control of the trader over the craftspersons increased. This phase is called proto-industrialization, a phase in which more and more people entered craft production. Traders established control over the workers and a large market for craft products developed across the world.